December may not be the height of tick season, but experts say there's still a concern any time of the year because they can spread Lyme disease.
It can be a serious disease, and when that that usually happens when the disease is not recognized. And when I said that sometimes there is no rash, the disease can progress without any treatment available, and that's when you see the complications of the disease.
One rare complication is a heart infection called Lyme carditis. A Centers for Disease Control report showed 3 people died from it. None were from New Jersey.
We do suspect that it is pretty rare, but given the tragedy of having young people die suddenly, we felt and still feel that it's very important to investigate them.
The 3 people who died are from Connecticut, Massachusetts, and New York State. They were relatively young, in their 20s and 30s, and none of them had been treated for Lyme disease. Experts say sometimes the symptoms aren't that severe or don't show up at all.
There are some infections where there is no rash. 20% may not have a rash. So the infection spreads throughout the whole body, and that's when, in the process of spreading, affects the joints, the heart, the central nervous system, by the way. You can also get meningitis from Lyme disease, and also affect the skin.
The CDC wants to raise awareness about Lyme carditis, but officials point out it is rare.
Lyme carditis among all patients that are reported to the CDC with Lyme disease is relatively rare. About 1% of patients who are reported to have Lyme disease have Lyme carditis. And we think that sudden cardiac death associated with Lyme carditis is even more rare.
Effective treatments are available for most cases of Lyme disease and other tick-borne illnesses, provided prompt medical care is sought from doctors who are familiar with the disease. There were more than 2,700 confirmed cases in New Jersey last year, and no deaths have been reported. People most at risk live or frequent wooded areas where ticks can get on your clothes. Experts recommend removing them with tweezers. In Montclair, I'm Desiree Taylor, NJTV News.